As we saw in the pre-analysis step, one can reduce the numerical error by increasing the order of interpolation within each element, or by refining the mesh using more elements. ANSYS already using the second order interpolation, and in practice you rarely go over second order interpolation, so what we need to do is to use more elements, i.e. refine the mesh. I'll show you a way to do this using what is called adaptive mesh refinement, which is pretty cool. So I will keep this original project, and I will go to, I'll right-click on model and say duplicate. Okay, so it hasn't duplicated the geometry. It's using just a reference, and same for the engineering data. So I can't modify the geometry here. I have to go over here, and it'll affect both projects, but I can change the mesh over here. I'll call this mesh 2, and then I'll right click and say edit. I can go into my mesh settings, so I'll go under mesh sizing. If you remember, you know, we can change the curvature, normal angle, the growth rate. We can also put in a sizing for edges or for faces, which you might have seen in other contexts using mesh control sizing. Instead, what I'll do is I'll get ANSYS to refine the mesh where it is, you know, where you have high gradients using adaptive meshing. So before that, I want to make sure I'm looking along Z over here. Maybe zoom in a little bit over there. Move this a little bit closer here. Okay. And what I'll do is I will go back to the defaults on the curvature normal angle. I'll start off with a coarse mesh, and I'll have ANSYS refine it automatically. So if I type in 0 in any field, I'll get the default. So I'll change the two settings that I used originally, the growth rate and the curvature normal angle, back to the default by entering 0. And then if I update the mesh, okay, I'm getting a very coarse mesh, and then I can resolve the problem and do ask it to do the post-processing on that mesh. And if I look at sigma x, you see that the stress concentration factor has dropped below 3. So now let's get ANSYS to refine the mesh. And I will turn on the show elements here. And what I'll do is I will highlight sigma x, and I'll right click and say insert convergence. Okay. And I'll say, you know, refine the mesh until the maximum value of sigma x changes by less than 0.1%. Okay, that's usually in practice, you don't go that low. This is an academic problem, so I'm getting greedy. And also, I can, you know, and it'll refine it only one level, and I played around with this. I'll ask it, hey, you know, try this, do the refinement 4 times, and you'll see the effect of this. And just for the heck of it, let's also track, you know, let's also insert the convergence on the deformation. So it'll, you know, as it's refining the mesh, it'll calculate what the change is in the deformation and sigma x. And this also, I'll say 0.1%. Okay. And then I'll highlight sigma x because I want to see the mesh as it's being refined. And then I will click solve. Okay, so that's after the first level of refinement. That's our second level. And see, it's only, you know, the higher the gradients, the more it's refining it. Okay, so you can see that it refined it, you know, the most where I have the stress concentration. That's pretty cool because the mesh is adapting to the solution. And if I come here, okay, it's showing me originally I had 319 nodes, and it's gone all the way to, you know, over 3,000 nodes. And the change in the latest refinement was 0.13%, which is above 0.1, which is why it's showing me this red exclamation. So if I change this to 0.2, that should go away. Okay? And if you look at this particular convergence, you see that as it refined the mesh, that the maximum deformation didn't change very much. So deformation, convergence much more quickly than the stresses. That's because you have to differentiate the displacement field to get the stresses, and anytime you differentiate a numerical result, you're going to magnify the errors. So really, I didn't need this convergence object, and usually you do the refinement on stresses, on one Mises stress, or in this case, sigma x works well, and you see that stress concentration factor is now, over 3. It's like 3.035, if I divide that maximum value by 20,000. So that's a neat way to refine the mesh. And if you want to get back the original mesh, see, it hasn't changed the original mesh. So you can see this only in the result. And if you want to change the convergence and so on, I found that I have to actually delete this and then say clear generated data. Okay. And then I can also delete this convergence. And then say solve. So I'm back to the original mesh, and then I can redo that convergence, which you know how to do now. Sometimes it can be hard to recover from convergence, and so I thought I'd show you that. So I'll save the project. And at this point, it's also a good idea to overwrite the WBPZ. So I'll say File Archive, and I'll overwrite the WBPZ.